Jesus not only had strong women friends, but seemed to run into them at every corner of his daily round. He finds a woman in the day at the well in Samaria, a place that neither one of them were supposed to be. Water was drawn in the early morning hours or late at night. And to put it directly and practically, Jesus was a part of the people who even Scripture tells us had nothing to do with Samaritans. But there they were. And she knew, and he knew, that the conversation, if there was any, would be fawned upon not only by his people, but by her people. Still, she engages him and is on the defense all day long, challenging his every word, his every assertion, protecting herself from his probing questions. Finally, Jesus breaks through that exterior and hears her say, "I know the Messiah is coming, who is called Christ. When he comes, he will proclaim all things to us." Then Jesus said, "I am he, the one who is speaking to you." And she doesn't ponder. She goes off and becomes one of the first evangelists by returning to his village and saying, "Come and see a man who told me everything I have ever done. He cannot be the Messiah, can he?" He was, and she was right to proclaim him so. But she never would have made the discovery had she not been willing to debate in broad daylight at the town watering hole. But perhaps the best confrontation of all comes in today's gospel, where Jesus meets a woman who is not only tenacious, but who absolutely refuses to take no for an answer. She will not be denied. This is a difficult story for me, perhaps even for you, because of the way Jesus treats this woman. First, he ignores her, and then he insults her, while the disciples are telling her to beat him. All of them are not behaving at their best. And to make matters worse, when the woman comes and kneels before him, a sign of perfect submission, he says to her, "It's not fair to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." The only trouble is, he has gotten himself into a verbal battle with one dog who is not going to put her tail between her legs and go away. Instead, she bites him back. Bites him right in, well, she bites him back. What she says is, "That may be so. Yes, Lord. But even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the master's table." It was a gotcha moment. Jesus had met his intellectual and spiritual edge. He may have been great in his debates with the scribes and the Pharisees, but here is one that he lost. As a matter of fact, he not only lost, he looked bad in the losing. Because she is telling him directly that if his ministry doesn't include her and her daughter, it doesn't include anybody. If it's not for her and her daughter, it's not for anybody. and what he has been telling people about God's love being open for all, if it's not open for her daughter, it's a lie. And he, if he hangs on to that lie, will suffer a loss of credibility second to none. All he can do is rear back on his heels, perhaps surprised by her left jab, and admire her strength, her courage, and her faith. Now, I think Jesus had such an affinity for strong women because a strong woman raised him. His mother Mary was no pushover either. She had to be strong to do what she did. First, even there when the angel Gabriel came to visit her, she didn't just take the angel's word, but made poor Gabriel explain himself in great detail. And even so, she then accepted the will of God for her life. She still had to face the real danger that her beloved Joseph would leave her, trying to resign and face as well, if not the verbal questions, at least the questions on the faces of her neighbors and friends. Sometimes she didn't even understand what her son was doing, but still she let him know to do what he had to do. And she loved him enough to stay with him, even to be there with him at the foot of the cross. And beyond that, to experience his resurrection. The encounters with Jesus brought out the best in these women, just as they should bring out the best in us. Loved and accepted, we can be like them and the other great women through the centuries. Mother Teresa, Rosa Parks, strong women to name but a couple, and stand up for what is right in the face of injustice. Loved and accepted by Jesus, we can be brave, strong. We can be what we were meant to be. Loved and accepted by Jesus, we can serve not out of submission, but out of a desire to really help those who need us. Loved and accepted by Jesus, we can accept others because we have felt his acceptance. I think this is the lesson that all of those strong women who surrounded Jesus and the strong women who bore him and brought him up teach us. That because of Jesus, we too can be like all the faithful men and women who follow Jesus through the ages. If we but an example of the women in Jesus' life.